Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about six super classic pairs of designer shoes and the sizing for these shoes. Now, when I was buying these six pairs of shoes, I had a really hard time trying to figure out what size to buy because a lot of these I did purchase online, and sizing between different designers can really, really vary, and also sometimes between shoes from the same designers. So I thought I would make this video for you guys just to help you guys out in case you're thinking about buying any of these shoes, and especially if you're going to buy any of these shoes online. Six different shoes that I'm going to be talking about today in terms of sizing are the Gucci Jordan Loafer, the Valentino Rock Stud Pump, the Ferragamo Vara Bow Block Heel, John Vito Rossi Plexi Pump, Chloe Lauren Scalloped Block Heels, and the Chanel Classic Ballet Flat. I'm going to be going through the sizing for all six of these shoes, so let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I wanted to tell you guys is my actual shoe size. So I am a true size 6 and a European size 36. So that will just give you guys a little bit of context and reference as I'm going through these shoes. So the first pair that I have here are the Gucci Jordan Loafers. The Jordan Loafers are the ones that are just the regular loafer. They don't fold down in the back, so you cannot wear these as a mule. Now with these loafers, I did buy these in half size down, so these are a 35 and a half. So when I bought these shoes, I initially bought them in both a 35 and a half and a size 36. The size 36 felt a little bit loose. When I read reviews for these online, people did say that the Gucci loafers tend to stretch out. And then actually I did go in stores as well, and the sales associate who was helping me also said the same thing. So he said that if your feet are narrow or regular width, then you should just size down half a size, because he said that the leather on these does stretch out. So the size 35 and a half that I have here, when I first got them, they fit really, really snug. So I wouldn't say that they were small, I would just say that they were like, you know, perfect snug fit. So definitely in the beginning it was hard to get my foot in. It's just because this opening, you know, just isn't wide enough, and this part is so long, so it's just hard to get your foot in. But once I got my foot in, it just felt really, really snug. But it felt like as I wore the shoe in, the leather would give, and then it would fit perfectly. So now you can see that, you know, I've kind of worn these a little bit. There's like creases and stuff in them. They do fit a little bit looser. I don't feel like I've completely broken them in. I primarily wear these at the office, and I'm not really walking around that much. I'm usually sitting down or standing, so I don't have a good opportunity to really break these in. But just from wearing them at the office, I feel like they have loosened up a little bit. My recommendation for the Gucci Jordan loafers are that if you have narrow to regular width feet, definitely size down half a size. If your feet are on the wider size, size up half to one size. My sister did size up a full size for these because she does have wider feet. And even when she sized up a full size, she still felt like they were very snug in the beginning. She has said that her loafers have loosened up with wear as well. Okay, so the next pair of shoes that I have here are the John Vito Rossi Plexi Pumps. So these shoes are, you know, leather. These shoes come in a lot of different materials, like for the toe part. The ones that I have here are in the black suede. The sides here on these shoes are plastic. I got these in my normal size 36. I did not size up or down. I will say that these are extremely tight, and I think it's because of the plastic. As you wear them, the natural body heat does tend to make them a little bit softer, so I wouldn't necessarily say that they stretch, but they do get softer over time. Now for these shoes, I did initially try a 36 and a half as well, but the size 36 and a half were definitely too big, so they already felt pretty loose to begin with. Like when I walked, the heel did slide off, so I definitely didn't think that I could size up. I feel like for these, you just kind of have to bear through that initial snugness and tightness. But as you wear them in, I feel like they do kind of mold to your feet, and they do, you know, soften up a bit, so they're not as difficult to wear. Because there's not that much leather on the front, and it's really just the toe part, I really wouldn't count on, you know, the leather stretching out to give you any additional room. It's really up to the plastic part to kind of soften up to make these a little bit more comfortable. But I would say that these fit pretty true to size. The only discomfort that you might experience initially with the Plexi Pump that might make the heel feel like it's too small is the fact that the plastic is just so stiff. So it feels like it cuts in a little bit right here, But again, you know, after a couple of wears with mine, they definitely softened up and they weren't quite as uncomfortable. With the Jean Vito Rossis, I would say stick to your normal size. Don't size up, don't size down, unless you have wider feet. Then I would say you'd want to size up an entire size. I don't think a half size would be enough just because of how narrow these shoes are and then how little give the plexi plastic has. All right, so the next pair of shoes that I have here are the classic Chanel ballet flats. And for these, I did pick these up in my normal size 36. For these ones as well, I tried both a 36 and a 36 and a half. Size 36 felt extremely snug. For Chanel flats, I would definitely say to stick with your normal size. They will feel really snug in the beginning, but the leather does loosen up quite a bit as you wear them in. And I really, really like Chanel flats because as you wear them, I feel like the leather really molds to your feet. And they're just really comfortable after you start to wear them. Initially, they can feel quite stiff and, you know, not as comfortable, but definitely over time, I would say that these are extremely, extremely comfortable. If you have narrow to normal width feet, I would say get your normal size. They'll loosen up and mold to your feet. But if you have wide feet, definitely size up half a size. Okay, so the next pair of shoes that I have here are the Valentino Rock Studs. This one is in the highest heel. I forget what the heel height is, but for these ones, let's see. Okay, so these ones I sized up half a size. So I got these in a size 36 and a half. I had to size up half a size because of the pointed toe. So normally when I wear like regular brand shoes that have a pointed toe, for example, like Everlane shoes or Tory Burch, like non-designer shoes, I can just stick to my normal size, a size 6 or a size 36. But for whatever reason with designer shoes, whenever it's a pointed toe, I always have to size up half a size. I'm not sure why it is, but the pointed toe really makes the shoe fit like a little bit smaller. And so I size up half a size really because if I just went with my normal size, my heel like hangs off just a little bit. And then also the front is extremely, like it pinches my feet right here on the size for the normal 36. So with the Valentino Rock Studs, I would highly, highly recommend sizing up half a size. When you do size up half a size, these are extremely comfortable. Even in this highest heel height, I don't experience like any pinching here. It's just really, really comfortable and they fit really well. Like my foot, you know, fits like ends perfectly where the shoe ends. And yeah, it just is like a perfect fit. So definitely for the Valentino Rock Studs, size up half a size. If you're getting the highest heel and you have wide feet, you might want to try sizing up by an entire size. But if you're going to go for like the flat or the lower kitten heel, you could just do half a size. I think that would be enough for the Valentino Rock Studs. All right, so the next pair of shoes that I have here is the Ferragamo Vara Block Bow Heel. I always like forget what the actual official name is called, but I think this pair of shoes is called the Vara Pump. These are the classic Ferragamo heels with like their signature bow here. For these, I went with my normal size 36. They fit like a dream, super comfortable. Really didn't have a break-in period. With the Ferragamo Varas, I would definitely say stick with your true size. All right, and then the very last pair of shoes that I have here is the Chloe Lauren Scalloped Pump. Now for these heels, just like the Ferragamo Varas, I would recommend sticking with your normal size. So for this one, I purchased these in a size 36 and they fit really, really well. Same thing as the Varas, didn't take any sort of breaking in. It doesn't pinch anywhere. The leather is just, you know, super soft, molds to your feet instantly. They're just really easy to wear, really comfortable. And yeah, they fit really true to size. All right, guys, so that's it for this video. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I know that when I was buying these designer shoes, it was seriously so hard for me to decide, you know, which sizes to get. I didn't know if I should size half a size up, half a size down, or just stick with my true size. So I hope this video was helpful. Of course, if you can go into the stores and try these shoes on, that's always the best, but in the event that you can't, I hope that the information I provided in this video does help you guys out to some extent. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I do post videos every single week about fashion, life, and luxury. So if you don't want to miss out, definitely hit the subscribe button. I'll link all of these shoes down in the description box below, and I'll also link my blog and my Instagram. All of the shoes that I showed today, I picked up on sale for really, really great discounts. For example, like the Gucci loafers I picked up, I got them for $300 off the retail price, which is absolutely insane because the Gucci Jordan loafers never go on sale. But I often will post sales and deals on my blog. So if you guys are into designer shoes, designer bags, you know, clothes, things like that, definitely check out my blog because I post sales there. So it's really great just to be notified of when you can, you know, get a great deal on a designer item. And if you want to see what I'm wearing on a day-to-day basis, I do post my outfits of the day on Instagram, so make sure to check out my Instagram if you're interested in getting daily outfit inspiration. All right guys, thank you again so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.